Let us start with the property diagrams now, and the first diagram we're going to talk about is the temperature volume diagram. Now, the phase change process of water at 1 atmospheric pressure or 0.1 megapascal. So this is a conversion which we need to understand and remember. So the phase change process of water at 0.1 megapascal was, you know, described in the previous video, and we had a TV plot for that process. Now let us repeat this process at different pressures to develop TV diagram. Okay, so the setup was something like this. So you had a piston and a cylinder arrangement, okay, like this, and inside we had some gas. All right, so now let us add weights on top of the piston. Okay, let's add some weights on top like this. Let's add some pebbles, considering we are little kids. All right, so we have added pebbles on top, and we are increasing the pressure inside the gas. And let us say the pressure inside the gas has now become 1 megapascals. Okay, so if you look at this diagram over here, that is the TV plot. Okay, so this TV plot, that is for the atmospheric pressure of 0.1 megapascals, and these points are saturated liquid points, and these two points are saturated vapor points. Okay, now when you increase the pressure to 1 megapascal, the new TV plot would be this particular line. Now what are some differences? But if you look at these two lines, that is for 0.1 MPa and for 1 MPa, the lines look similar. Okay, but there are some noticeable differences. The first difference is that the water now boils at a much higher temperature as compared to 0.1 megapascal. So water used to boil at 100 degrees Celsius at 0.1 megapascal. Now at 1 megapascal, the water will now start to boil at around 180 degrees Celsius. So there is an increase in the boiling temperature as you increase the pressure. The second noticeable difference, if you look at the case of saturated liquid, okay, the specific volume of the saturated liquid is larger as compared to 0.1 megapascal. So if you look at 0.1 megapascal, the specific volume is this of the saturated liquid. But if you look at the saturated liquid volume for 1 megapascal, the volume increases. So there is an increase in the volume of the saturated liquid state at a high pressure. But the volume, or the specific volume of the saturated vapor state, is smaller than the corresponding values at 0.1 megapascal. So this is the value at 0.1 megapascal. And this is the value which occurs at 1 megapascal. So there is a decrease in specific volume of saturated vapor, and there is an increase in the value, or in the value of specific volume for saturated liquid. So if you look at the line, or the horizontal line which connects the saturated liquid and the saturated vapor points, that line is much shorter. So if you look at the case of 0.1 megapascal, so the horizontal line is this much long, but in case of 1 megapascal, this horizontal line has decreased in length. Okay, so this is, or these are some noticeable differences that would, you know, occur as you increase the pressure inside the gas cylinder. Alright, now as the pressure is increased further, okay, you can see that the saturation line, it keeps on decreasing in length. Okay, and it becomes a single point when the pressure reaches 22.06 megapascals. So this is a very important, you know, value to note down, because at this point, we call this point as the critical point. So this is the critical point. Now, why we call it such a name? Because at this particular point, that is the critical point, the saturated liquid and the saturated vapor, they are identical. Okay, so let me write down the definition of this, because if you can see that this horizontal line is connecting the liquid and vapor phases at saturated conditions. So as you keep on increasing the pressure of the system, this horizontal line, it starts to decrease in length, and at a pressure of 22.06 megapascal, this now becomes only a point, that is the saturated liquid state and the vapor state, they are both identical. Okay, so this brings us to a point where we define that what is critical point. So it is a point at which the saturated liquid and the saturated vapor states are identical. Alright, so this is how we define critical point. Okay, so the temperature, the pressure and the specific volume of a substance at critical point are respectively called the critical temperature. So the temperature at this point would be called the critical temperature. Alright, the pressure is called the critical pressure, and the volume would be called the critical volume. So this is a very, very important point as far as a substance is concerned. Okay, now there are some specific values of this critical point for a substance, and the critical point properties of water. This is something that you should remember by heart. Okay, so the critical pressure for water is 22.06 megapascals. All right. The specific volume at critical point, or the critical specific volume of water, is 0.003106 meter cube per kg, and the critical temperature for water would be 373.95 degrees Celsius. So these data values are for critical point of water. Okay, so go ahead and make a note of these values. Okay, the other more commonly used value and most important one is that for a helium. Okay, so for helium, the critical pressure is 0.23 megapascals, so that's much lower as compared to what you have for water. Okay, the critical temperature is in minus, that is 267.85 degrees Celsius, and the critical specific volume is 0.01444 meter cube per kg. So these values are for helium. Okay, so now let us draw one more diagram to illustrate that what happens when you go beyond the critical pressure point in the TV plot. Okay, so this is a TV plot that you have. Okay, so let us say this is your critical temperature and this is your specific critical volume. Okay, and this is a normal phase change path that you have. Okay, and then this is what happens at the critical point. And let's now go above the critical pressure. So this is how it will look like. Now what is happening here is that this pressure is below the critical pressure. This is the critical pressure, PCR, alright. And this is the pressure which is above the critical pressure. Okay, so, right. So this phase is the liquid phase, that is L, alright. And this horizontal line, it indicates a phase change. So let us write down the word phase change over here, which is representing or which is represented by this horizontal line. This is your critical point, and whatever that lies beyond it is the vapor state. Okay. Now the thing is that at pressures above the critical pressures, there is not a distinction, or you can say there is not a distinct phase difference or a phase change process, because the liquid and vapor states, they coincide at a single point. Okay. At critical point and above, it is all, you know, an ambiguous situation. So instead, the specific volume of the substance continuously increases, and at all times there is only one phase present, that is the vapor state. Eventually it resembles the vapor. Okay. But we cannot tell that when the state has changed from vapor to liquid. So above the critical state, there is no line that separates the compressed liquid region and the superheated vapor region. However, it is customary to refer to the substance as a superheated vapor at temperatures above the critical temperatures and as compressed liquid at temperatures below the critical temperature. So this is a very, very important point to remember. That is, above TCR, we have to mention the substance as in the superheated vapor state. Superheated vapor, alright, and below the TCR, that is the critical temperature, the substance is referred to as in a compressed liquid state. Compressed liquid state, alright. Now, after the TV diagram, let's now move on to the second diagram that we call the PV diagram, that is the pressure volume diagram. So let's draw a pressure volume diagram now. Okay. Now the general shape of the PV diagram of a pure substance is very much like the TV diagram. Okay. But in a TV diagram, the line that denotes the temperature. Alright, so if you look at these two diagrams, so let me draw a TV diagram first. So this is how a TV diagram would look like, volume, temperature. Alright, let me draw this particular curve. Now this is the critical point, okay, this is CP. So this is the compressed liquid region. This is the superheated vapor region, and whatever that lies between these two regions is called the saturated liquid vapor region. So saturated liquid vapor region. So now the TV diagram for a pure substance would look like this. So you'll have a horizontal line and then it goes up. So this is how the TV plot looks like for a pure substance. Now if you draw a PV diagram of the same substance, it will be a very similar kind of a diagram, but the only difference is that in case of a TV plot, the temperature lines were a horizontal line, so this is a constant temperature line. But in case of a PV plot, the temperature lines, they have a downward trend. Alright, so let me just illustrate that. So we draw this dome, okay, which gives us the three phases. So this is the critical point on the PV plot. This is the compressed liquid region. This is the superheated vapor region. And this is the saturated liquid vapor region. Okay, now in this particular diagram, if I have to draw for the same pure substance, okay, you will have something like this. So this is how the temperature will come into picture, and this is how the whole thing goes. So this is a constant temperature line, or you can say an isotherm in a PV plot. Now, to understand it further, let us draw the piston cylinder arrangement once more. Alright, so this is the cylinder, this is the piston. Okay, now in this whole setup, the liquid water is at 1 megapascals and 150 degrees Celsius. So you have liquid water, the pressure is 1 megapascals, okay, and the temperature is 150 degrees Celsius. Okay, now at this particular state, the water is present in form of a compressed liquid, and you have some weights on top. Let's put some weights on top. Okay. And we are providing the heat from the bottom continuously. Okay. Now what we are doing is we are removing these weights one by one. So let us remove these weights gradually. Okay, now upon removing these weights gradually one by one, the pressure inside the cylinder decreases gradually. So the water is allowed to exchange heat with the surroundings, so its temperature remains constant. So as you remove this top weight, the pressure tries to, the pressure decreases and the piston moves up, and the system inside, it exchanges heat with the surroundings, so the temperature remains at 150 degrees Celsius only. Okay, so as the pressure decreases, the volume of the water increases. Okay, now when the pressure reaches the saturation pressure value at the specified temperature, so from tables we know that at 150 degrees Celsius, the saturation pressure is about 0.4762 megapascals MPa. Okay, so at this temperature, this is the saturation pressure, and at this particular pressure, the water starts to boil. Okay, and during the vaporization process, both the temperature and the pressure remain constant, but the specific volume increases. So this is what this whole, you know, diagram, which is the PV plot, is illustrating. So let us say initially you had your pressure at this particular point, and as you start decreasing the pressure, okay, keeping the temperature to be constant, because this is the isotherms have a downward trend. Okay, so the temperature also starts to fall a bit because the system exchanges heat with the surroundings. Okay, now when it reaches here, the vaporization starts at this saturation pressure. So this pressure is called the saturation pressure. Okay, the vaporization goes on, and when the vaporization is complete, the whole of the liquid inside has now transformed itself into vapor, and again you have your temperature like this, and you go into the superheated vapor region. Okay, so this was the PV plot in comparison to the TV, or the temperature volume plot. Okay, now let's extend these diagrams to include the solid phase. Now the two equilibrium diagrams that are developed so far, that is the TV plot and the PV plot, they represent the equilibrium states involving liquid and vapor phases only. However, these diagrams can easily be used to include the solid phase as well as the solid liquid and solid vapor saturation region. So now we will include these two regions as well. So the basic principles which are discussed with the liquid vapor phase change process, they also apply in the solid liquid and the solid vapor phase change processes. Okay, now when you have a liquid, and it solidifies or it freezes. Okay, so most of the substances, when they freeze, they contract, that is, their specific volume decreases. But there are some other substances which expand on freezing, and one of such substances is water. Okay, so let's draw the PV plots for these two classes of substances, the first one which expands on heating and the second one which contracts on heating. Okay, so this is the first diagram, and this would be a pressure volume diagram. Okay, so let's draw this dome like this. Okay, and this is how it looks like, this straight line, and then you have another straight line like this. Okay, now in this particular diagram, this is your critical point CP, isn't it? This is the vapor region. This is the region where you have a liquid plus vapor, alright, and this is the complete liquid region. And beyond liquid, you know, when you cool beyond liquid, you get solid plus liquid, and then you keep on cooling it, you get the complete solid phase, alright, and this becomes your solid plus vapor region. So this is a pressure volume diagram of a substance that contracts on freezing. So if you look at the specific volume of the liquid region, this is the specific volume, and when you have the complete frozen liquid, that is the solid region, the volume has gone down, so there is a decrease in the volume. So this is the contraction that takes place. So the diagram illustrates those solids which contract upon freezing. Now similarly, a similar diagram can be drawn for substances that expand on freezing, such as water. Okay, so let me draw another diagram for the anomalies such as water which expand when they freeze. So this is the pressure axis, this is the volume axis, all right. And this is the dome. Now in this, what is happening, this is representing that it expands upon freezing, all right, and this is the line that we have, and not the complete one, so this would be dotted and this would be solid. Yeah, so this is what you will have, and in this is the liquid plus vapor region, this is the vapor region, this is the liquid region, this would be the critical point. Okay, this is solid plus liquid and this is completely solid, and you can see that when the solidification completes, there is an increase in the volume. So this is for those substances which expand on freezing. Now the fact that the water expands upon freezing has vital consequences in nature. Okay, so if water contracted on freezing as most other substances do, the ice formed would be heavier than the liquid water, and it would settle to the bottom of rivers, lakes and ocean instead of floating at the top. So what you see now is that, let us say this is the river bed and the river is flowing on top like this. Okay, so when you have ice formation, okay, the ice formation, if the water contracted on freezing, the density of the ice would have been heavier than that of water, and you would have ice formation at the bottom of the lakes like this. Okay, but now what happens is ice floats on the water because it is lighter than water. Alright. And if this condition would have occurred, then if you, you know, talk about the sun's rays, so let us say this is your sun. Okay, so the rays of the sun, or the warmth of the rays of the sun, would never have, you know, reached the bottom of the river beds, so the ocean beds. Okay, and the bottom would have remained frozen for many, many years to come, and this would, you know, disrupt and disturb the marine life. So that is why the expansion of water upon freezing has a very significant effect on the natural scheme of things as well. Alright, now we are familiar with two phases being in equilibrium, but under some conditions all the three phases of a pure substance coexist. Okay, so if you look at a very simple diagram over here, so this is a container. Alright, so in this container, or let us say this is again a piston cylinder arrangement. So in this you have a vapor state. Okay, so this yellow region, this indicates the vapor state. Alright, and then we have the liquid state. This is liquid. And then we have the solid state, which is the frozen state. You have all solid liquid which has frozen up to make a solid. So this is vapor, this is liquid, and this is solid. Alright, now on PV and TV, that is pressure volume and temperature volume diagrams, these triple phase states, because in, let us say this is one state of a system and you have all the three phases present of the substance, so it is called a triple phase state. Okay, and on these two diagrams, that is pressure volume and temperature volume, these triple phase states form a line and we call it a triple line. Okay, and the triple line on the two diagrams above are these lines. So this is the triple line. Okay, and this is also a triple line because this is solid plus vapor. Alright, the states on the triple line of a substance have the same pressure and temperature but different specific volumes. So the triple line appears as a point on the PT diagram. Okay, so we'll discuss PT diagram in the next video. Alright, and this single point is also referred to as the triple point. So the triple point temperatures and pressures of various substances, okay, you don't need to know, you just need to know for water. So the triple point for water, that is when you have vapor, steam, when you have liquid water, and when you have ice all coexisting at the same point, okay, that is called the triple point. So triple point for water let us say TTR for water would be 0.01 degrees Celsius, and the triple point pressure for this would be 0.6117 kilopascals. 0.6117 kilopascals. So these are the triple point properties for water. Okay. So this finishes this video in which we discussed two phase diagrams or property diagrams, that is the TV plot and the PV plot. Okay, now in the next video we talk about the pressure temperature diagram.